I'm here in Oxnard, California with future champions Eric De Leon and KC Martinez. Both of them are sparring Brandon Rios as he's getting ready for the fight of his career against Manny Pacquiao. What do you guys think of the fight? November 24, Macau, China, HBO pay-per-view.
Can't wait, man.
It's gonna be a great fight. It's gonna be a whole bunch.
Very interesting fight. See how Pacquiao comes back from that great knockout from Juan Manuel Marquez. And Rios is more than ready right now. He's training really hard. He's disciplined himself a lot. Training hard, giving his best every day, working really hard. So he's going to be ready. He's going to be ready 100% when it comes to fight time. Hopefully Pacquiao is ready, because I know Brandon Rios is coming for that KO.
What's it like to be in the ring with him, KC? That's what you do for a living?
Yeah.
You get paid?
Yeah.
You get paid? How much fun do you have training with Brandon?
Well, I mean, it's fun. It's fun. It's real fun. You know what I'm saying? It's never a boring day. You know what I mean? But at the same time, it's real hard work. So I like it. I like it. And, you know, like you said, get paid for it. You know, that's cool.
It's a great experience.
Great experience. You get to go to China and stuff, you know. But yeah, I'm ready to see the fight, though. I know it's going to be really exciting, man. I'm ready to see it.
I lost $200 to Brandon over the last two fights. I usually don't bet. And the two bets that I had recently, I lost on Cotto and I lost on Alvarado.
Yeah.
How should I pay him the $200? Should I get singles? Should I get two bills?
Pennies. No, just pay him with quarters.
That'd be
pretty funny. Just pay him with quarters.
I'll do that.
And he'll probably be pretty mad about it.
Well, it comes in rolls. It comes in rolls of $5. So.
Oh, okay.
So I'm going to just take all the rolls and just roll them into the ring.
He'll probably give it to you back. He'll probably be like, I don't want this. Just bring me $200 bills. Now you should do that. And how he is, I'm pretty sure, he'll probably react to it really funny and stuff.
All right, I'll do that. When he gets his hands wrapped, I'll just drop it in his lap.
Like, you should.
That'd be funny.
Either that or silver dollar, like dollar coin. That's even less practical. Because quarters, at least you can use it when parking meters.
That'd be badass if you do that, too.
I try to get dollar bills and coins, I think, because you can't use them.
That's true.
Yeah.
You go to stores. So right here in Oxnard, you guys been boxing how many years now?
I've been boxing 12 years, going on 13.
I say, 11, 12 years.
That's crazy. 12-time national champion. Did you win any big tournaments, KC, growing up?
You know what I'm saying? Like, I won some out for Texas. I won the Golden Gloves, you know, states. For nationals, I went to that. I lost that one. But, I mean, before that, you know what I'm saying? I beat the under-19s. I went to Powell's. I beat that once or twice. I've had some good wins in amateurs.
How important is a great amateur background in order to turn pro? Do you regret staying an amateur? How old are you now?
I'm 21.
22.
You guys are very young
and you're pro.
Yeah.
With how many fights?
Amateur, I had over 150 amateur fights. I fought against the best in the U.S. and that was great for me. You know, now I'm pro. I'm 5-0 as a professional fighter. But it's really important to get as much experience as you can being an amateur. That way you see a lot of different styles. I competed in a lot of national tournaments and got the chance to fight with the top best amateurs in the U.S.
A bunch of styles and amateurs.
So now, it's a pleasure to spar with pros. I've been sparring pros since I won the first Golden Gloves.
Nonito, Brandon.
Nonito is a great fighter. Brandon, K-9, Demetrius Salida. Moved around with Andy Lee at the old crowd. I mean, just with a lot of great boxers. So to me, it's a great experience, learning experience, and it's a pleasure to go in there and sparring with the best in the world right now. It just makes me, you know, it motivates me to hopefully, you know, in a couple years be in that level too. So that's why we work hard every day, and you know, it's fun too. Oxnard is cool. There's great people. We're enjoying it.
Just a little chilly right now, but
just a little chilly right now.
At the moment, it's
gotta shake it off. But no, it's cool, man. It's great learning experience at the gym and great atmosphere. A lot of great people. Everybody treats you good, and you know everybody works hard and everybody motivates each other to do better. You know, and eventually Brandon Rios is working really hard, like I said, and he's getting ready to do big things in China.
You guys' prediction for Rios Pacquiao, how many rounds, or does Brandon win by decision? Does he win by knockout?
I think it's going to be a knockout.
Yeah.
It's going to be knockout.
Yeah, I mean.
What round?
I can't say what round, but if any, that's maybe 10 or 11. I think it's going to be late.
I don't see it going to the distance. I mean, they're both great fighters. They're both going to come to fight. They're both going to have a great plan. But they're both hungry because Pacquiao lost his last fight by knockout. And, you know, he gets into them fights. And Brandon Rios, you know what he does. He's an action-packed fighter. He comes to fight. You know, he comes to break your head, putting all that pressure. And it's going to be a great fight. Don't miss it. Everybody make sure to watch that fight.
Okay, let me ask you this. When Brandon beats Pacquiao, who do you want to see him fight next? Alvarado, Ruslan winner, which is Ruslan Provodnikov, who just won tonight, or would you want to see him fight Tim Bradley?
Oh, yeah.
They're both a great fight.
I think Tim.
Tim, not the Russian?
I want to see the Russian. Because of styles.
Bradley. I just want to see that O go away. That's what I want.
Don't hate.
I'm not hating. I'm joking.
He's got great boxing ability.
Yeah. Yeah, I think it'd be a good fight.
Okay.
Yeah, Bradley deserves a great fight, too, because he proved a lot of people wrong. He did good. He beat Marquez clean.
All right, let me ask you guys this one. Last question for today. Floyd Mayweather, Amir Khan, break it down. Looks like if that happens.
Easy work for Floyd.
Yeah.
What about Amir's speed, power, ring generalship?
Man, I don't know. I just think Mayweather's seen that before. He's boxed a lot of people. Yeah, Mayweather is real, real good. I think that's just easy work for him.
But you guys going to watch it? Okay.
I'm probably going to make some money off of it, too. You know?
Mayweather right now is doing, you know, after his last fight, he showed a lot of boxing ability. He's the top right now, top fighter to me. So I think it should be a good fight. Good, like you said, speed makes styles make fights. But Pacquiao's Mayweather is just too good, I think.
If he fights Pacquiao ever?
That's what I want to see, but I doubt that will ever happen.
Who wins that one?
Fight.
Floyd.
Yeah.
And you're from Detroit, right? Representing?
Yeah, from Detroit. That's right. He's from Grand Rapids. So you know what it is.
There you have it. Casey Martinez, freezing here in Oxnard. EsNewsReporting.com. Eric DeLeon. You can follow them on Twitter at Golden DeLeon and on Instagram
at Golden DeLeon 313.
Sorry, Golden DeLeon 313. And on
Kareem
Instagram,
KC.
Kareem KC.
KareemKC.
EsNewsReporting.com. I'm Ellie Segback reporting. And you can follow me on Twitter at Segback.